Late in the fourth, A.J. Green ran a sharp route to beat corner Logan Ryan one-on-one, and Andy Dalton hit him cleanly for a 70-yard touchdown that put the Bengals up 20-17. They were highlight plays that chewed up yardage and inflated the stat sheet, but the Bengals yet again struggled to move the ball consistently through the air in a 24-20 loss to Tennessee on Sunday afternoon. Dalton was 18 for 33, 54.5%, on his other throws, 7 of which were broken up by Titans defenders. "We didn't do a good enough job separating from them in situations," said Bengals head coach Marvin Lewis. "We're getting calls, and they're draped on us. Just look at it. We've got to do better. We understood how they were going to play, and we've got to do a better job of creating separation." The issue has plagued the Bengals for the better part of the year, with too few opportunities for easy throws and catches like the Bengals saw on two occasions Sunday. Story from TriHealth. Why hernia patients need core strength. The amazing benefits of exercise before and after surgery. They grab a lot. They grab a lot, Green said with a slight smile. But they're not going to call a lot those grabs, so we've got to run through them. You've got to be physical with that. Just run through all the grabs and hope they make the call. Some calls they're not going to call. On Sunday, the Titans challenged the Bengals' pass catchers to win one-on-one, and they only paid the price twice. And it was almost three times. Dalton saw rookie John Ross singled up outside on the second play of the second quarter, and the quarterback decided to give the wideout a chance to win. Only it fell harmlessly to the turf, as Ross stopped running for a critical moment. "That was all my fault," Ross said. "I kinda messed up what I had to do. I think it's a slim chance he's supposed to do something like throw to me, so that was all my fault. It had nothing to do with him. I think it was a great ball. I've got to just listen to what I was told and continue to do it right instead of wrong." The Bengals averaged a respectable 7.5 yards per pass play, but that was due in large part to the long touchdowns. Outside of Green and LaFell, 11 catches on 17 targets, there wasn't much happening downfield. Tight end Tyler Croft caught one of his 6 passes for 4 yards, while receivers Josh Malone and Alex Erickson each caught a pass. "We knew they were going to be handsy out there. We knew they played a lot of man coverage, so we've just got to do a better job of getting hands off, and I know myself, personally, making those contested catches," Croft said. The issues there contributed to an offensive showing that included just 1 third down conversion on the day, a 15 total first downs and 7 possessions that ended in a punt, including 5 in the second half. The Bengals recorded a single first down in the third quarter and had just 2 in the fourth, including 1 on Green's long touchdown. "You've got to beat man coverage," Dalton said simply. "For us to do what we want to do and to have the production we want to have, we have to do it every time. That's the goal. That's the expectation. We'll look at it and see what we can do better, and all we can do is work on it from here."